Mrs. Pettibone. Now it all happened in a little country town. The Women's Guild were holding their annual Friday afternoon meeting. Miss Mary Baldwin Thayer, the 58-year-old president, virgin to the end, arose and said, "Girls, you remember last Friday we took up the subject of old Japan. Lousy country. But this being the last Friday before our birthday, we're going to take up a subject very near your heart, but very rarely mentioned in this thriving community. Sex. Hot, hot sex. And marriage. So I'm going to call on Mrs. Pettibone, who has buried three husbands, to tell us everything she knows. Now Mrs. Pettibone arose fair, fat, and 40 with a twinkle. She was like that all day long, was biological. She said, "Ladies of the guild and your distinguished presence, I'm sure you expect me to tell you far more than I know. But any information I can give you, I will give you with all my heart. Now, as you all know, my first husband, Mr. Black, had a club foot and a bad case of halitosis. All I can say about our marital relations, they were lousy. Now, my second husband, Mr. Thayer, related to your dear, dear president, was an extraordinarily well-built man to look upon outside the home. But inside the home, what a frost. He was too little to talk about. I called him numbnuts. When he died, I buried him with nothing but a burp. But now, ladies of the guild, lend me your ears. My last husband, Mr. Pettibone, was a man. In every sense of the word, as you all know too damn well. I'll never forget our wedding night. God, what a night. We went to Fall River and had a big fish dinner. Why, I will never know. Directly after dinner, he said, "Let's go upstairs." And I thought, oh, hell, I've done this so many times. Well, we went upstairs anyway to a little room overlooking a lot of factories and the old Fall River line. As I stood there wondering what in hell he was going to do next, suddenly, without a word of warning, he popped out of his clothes and plunged into an old hot tub. Meanwhile, I peeked to the door and was not too displeased. And being an old-timer, I jumped into bed myself and said, "Come what may!" When suddenly the bathroom door opened and out came Mr. Pettibone. Just as naked as a child and twice as cocky. He came over the bed and he clapped his hands and he clicked his heels and he said, "And now, Mrs. Pettibone, if you please."